One's just automatically locked, and the other one is a what you call it box. So that ain't nobody can get in like that. So, and then I have to use both keys, that's all. Okay? And just in case that you forget or something other, have the front door locked instead of bolted. Okay? Thank you. No, I haven't made no money. Rick is here and he's taking pictures. He wanted to take pictures of my place and so, yeah. Oh, well, okay, I'll tell him you say hi. Yeah, okay. No, he's by himself. I don't know why he wants the pictures, but I do not know. Well, what difference would it make? Sabina wanna know why do you want these pictures?
Well, I told you I'm making a documentary.
He said he's making a documentary or something like that. I think that's what he said. I don't know what he means. You know what I mean?
It's a movie about your records.
Oh, she said that's. He said that's a movie about my records. Oh, okay. Oh, I see. I suppose. I don't know. I didn't ask him. I didn't ask him no question. Okay, get off my phone now. Let the talk box rest. Okay. Bye-bye.
Bye.
I sell mostly tapes, and here of late, all they want is casinos. They think everything should become in a casino.
Not the whole album?
They think that everything is on a casino. If it's not on casino, they said it will be. They wait. And a lot of things that they play from the radio is on a LP or the CD or whatever you want to call it, but people that come in, they want a casino. They even come in asking for old stuff. They want a casino. And you can't get it. You can't even get some of the old full albums or the full tapes or whatever. There's certain stuff you can't get. But the customer, they don't see it that way. I know you got it. But yeah, you got it. Yeah. And they look like they get upset if I don't go looking for it or something. I don't suppose to look for something I know I don't have.
So, but you got all you have out here is albums.
Yeah, mostly in the front here, albums and the old 45s. All my tapes, you put them in the back, otherwise you won't have any.
And you don't even have anything to display them with?
Well, no, I could display them, but then that, if you display something, it's like setting a TV on the counter and watching it, and the people see it, and then at night when you leave, they break in and snatch it and run. And so you, even if they don't get stuff, they break your windows and stuff, so you gotta keep it hid as much as possible.
Even with all the bars on your windows?
Bars doesn't mean a thing. They take the cars or the trucks and pull the whole front off. Doesn't mean anything.
Wow. So how do people buy things here then?
How do they buy?
Do you have to? Do they come in and ask for it? How does it go?
Well, that's the only way I sell anything. I have to know what I'm looking for in order to try to sell it. And when they ask me for stuff I don't know, I write it down and then a lot of time I have the stuff that they want, but they asked about the wrong name. And so I don't sell that.
Like what's an example?
Well, for instance, a guy asked me for Yo Homie. And I didn't know that was gangster in me. So I got to answer the phone now.
Okay. All right. We'll get there.
most of these records were named. But
what do you mean by named?
Like, you see, Albert King and B.B. King.
By the artists, you mean?
All the Kings was here. Edmund Starvel and Ernest Jackson was in this box. Isaac Topple, Earth Wind, Rare Earth, Gene Channel. It was in certain boxes. And so I knew exactly which box that I'd go to find what I was looking for. But right now I can't, because since I've been like I am and different people come in, and I may have some records here that I don't even know I got.
What about the different types of music? Where were they all? I mean, did you separate those out?
Sure. The blues was in one section, and the jazz was over in the section over there. Most stuff over here was either pop, I guess what you call pop swing stuff, dance music stuff. And then when they started bringing out that rap crap, I had it all right in this, long in here. Of course, I done moved it. Now, I don't know why I put that stuff, because I never understood nothing. I didn't know it. Same word over and over. Blah, 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 blah. I didn't know what they were saying, no way.
Did you ever sell any rock and roll?
Rock and roll? What do you mean when you said rock and roll?
Well, you know, rock music.
No, I have, I got a bunch of, I don't know, what you call it, the music that Tom Jones and them kind of folks put out.
Oh, yeah.
That rock?
Yeah, it could be, yeah.
Okay, then I have that in these boxes on. They was in certain boxes. I didn't have that mixed with the others.
That been up there?
How long has that been left? Well, it's been here as long as I've been here. I've been here since 72. But I had it when I was on 69th Street.
They gave it to you for free?
Yes, I got that. I believe it was, I believe that came from Singer One Stop. Singer had a one stop on Chicago Avenue and one down there on Halsted. And then they moved from on Halsted out to on 63rd, on West 63rd. And then they closed that up and they were just on Chicago Avenue. And then I think they closed up completely.
So who did you?
You might know Singer. He's a Caucasian. He was pretty decent person to deal with, I say. But actually, you know, over the years, there was Garner's One Stop, there was Lynette One Stop, there was Ernie's One Stop. Of course, that guy over here on 75th Street, I forget his name now, but
that's Mr. Fletcher, right?
Fletcher, yeah. I went over there, I called him up, and they told me they had some stuff, and I go there, they'll let me have two of this and two of that. And I said, I probably better let them keep this for themselves. So I quit going over there.
So who have you been?
Maybe he done changed and got be different now. I don't know. Maybe I ought to try him again. I don't know.
Yeah, I know he's still over there.
Yeah, I go down that street. I see the sign.
Yeah, he's got a store of his own, too, over there.
No, the one stop it's just like here, I would say, but he sold to the stores and to the public as well out of the same place.
Mm-hmm.
At least that's where he was. That's where it was when I was going over there. Place wasn't no bigger than... I don't know if it's as big as this, but I don't know how big it was in the back.
Mm-hmm.
You know, because of the little hole that you came in the front.
Yeah.
You stood there while they get the stuff.
Mm-hmm.
It didn't appear to me there's much room in there to where in here. I mean, you know, it's not very much room in here.
How many cassettes you sell a day, you think?
Gee, that's sometimes I sell one mini. Sometimes I don't sell anything. Sometimes there's four or five people will come in here and ask for stuff. And when they look at, they want to know how much it is, or I just want to know, did you have it? And they have me to go get it and bring it up and they look at it. Oh, I just want to know if you had it. They don't buy anything. I've been here for weeks and not sell anything. But,
so why do you keep doing it?
One or two, well, here comes someone that really wants one, and maybe I don't have it, and I'll promise them I'll go pick it up. I go to pick that up, then you see something else that they got new, and you'll bring that back. And so this is why, I guess.
But you don't really sell enough to support yourself at this point,
no,
do you?
No, I don't.
Why do you keep on doing it, then?
Because I got a lot of crap in here, I don't know what to do with it, and I just comes over here because I get tired of sitting at home. There's some place to go.
Mm-hmm.
As I said before, I'm retired.
Yeah.
I wait on the third for that little Social Security pennies. That's it. And that ain't much, but I come to expect I'm gonna get them three or four pennies, and I wait on them.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know, sometimes the pennies I tie them up in the records. And I don't know where my little check is until I look around and I say, oh, I bought this and I bought that. And it don't really make no sense.
Mm-hmm.
Sometimes I look at my own self and say, you're stupid.
Do you really like selling records a lot? I mean, would you say that you're a record guy? Or?
No, I really don't know. I don't think I am, because when I even play the radio, I hear that stuff and it bounces and I don't even know what they're saying. All the crap sound alike.